Yeah, hello everyone. So today let's see your execution of your project. So first of all, what you're going to do is enable your PyCharm. So when you click on this PyCharm, you'll be getting this PyCharm option here. Run as administrator. Your PyCharm will be turned on. So meanwhile, turn on your VAM server. So VAM server will be turned on. So as soon as you have turned on your VAM server, you'll be getting a green color icon over here. Click on this and click on start all services. Your VAM server will be turned on. So after turning on your VAM server, so what you do is click on this and click on PHP MyAdmin. Your PHP MyAdmin would be opened in the browser. It would be opened in the browser. So here I have configured my browser. In that, my PHP MyAdmin has been opened. So let us wait for it. So I have opened PyCharm. So it is asking to close. So go to your PyCharm. So click on file. Click on file. Click on open. So when you click on open, it will ask you to show the location of your project. So now what I do, where your project is there, go to the particular location. So I have placed it here. I have extracted it. After extracting, I got my directory over here. So open this directory. In that, go to your project folder and find where is the manage.py file. If you can find manage.py file, that would be your working directory. So here manage.py is here. So this is what my directory of my project. So now what I'd be doing is copy this path, right? So like my project is in this particular location, so I copy it here. I come to PyCharm and paste it here, right? So by doing this, my project would be opened in the PyCharm. My project would be opened in the PyCharm. So after opening the project in the PyCharm, so you can see the structure over here. So in this, again you can find your project folder. Go to that folder, go to settings.py file there. So in this you can find your Django version, database details and so on. So right now go a little bit down, find the database details option over here. Copy this database name. After copying this database name, so come back to PHP MyAdmin. Come back to localhost. Come back to PHP MyAdmin. So username is root and password is empty as discussed. So click on go. So by doing this, what would be happened is, you would be able to go to your database admin. So click on database here. Give the database name. So paste the database name what you have copied over there. So this is opinion mining. So I have given opinion mining. Click on create. So by doing this, my database will be created here. So after creating the database, you won't get these tables. So in order to get these tables, now what we need to do is select your database. After selecting a database, click on import option. So last to choose a file. So click on this choose file. By choosing this file, it moves to some other directory. So go to the directory where your database is there. So here I'm able to find my project complete code. So I'll be going back. So here I can find my database. So go to the directory, go to your project directory, documentations, videos or database. So check where your database is there. So your database file would be as SQL file. So file type is SQL. So it means it is a database of your project. So please select that and click on go. So by doing this, you would be able to import your database. So it takes a little bit of time. So it will be done. So let it done at the back end. So after doing with it, now we have gone with this thing. So now we need to install Django in a PyCharm. So how do we install the Django in PyCharm is, so here go to settings.py file. A specific version of Django would be displayed. So that should be installed. So how do you install is, in the below click on terminal, you will be getting this. So here write down the command. So now what you do is, you need to write down the command. So what is the command, I'll show you. So pip space install space django equal to 1.11.5. So in your settings, what are the versions is, that version you need to install it. So this is what my version for this particular project. I come back to PyCharm here and I paste that command. So Django would be installed. Django would be installed in my directory. Django would be installed. So after installing Django, now you need to install the next command. For this you require the internet. If you are having internet only, that would be installed. And defaultly you need to have the database, pip space install space my SQL client equal to 1.3.12. So this is for the standard version for your database. Copy this command. So after installing Django, then you need to go with that particular command. So by doing this, your Django would be installed in your system. So after installing Django in your system, you need to install MySQL. Right, so let us wait, it is taking a little bit of time. Based upon the system speed, this can be done. Based upon the system speed, this can be done. Right, so now after this, it is done. So now next command, pip space install space MySQL client equal to 1.3.12. So by doing this, MySQL client would be installed. So why this, what would be happened is, your project, the Django framework would be integrated to your database, I mean the MySQL. So this would be integrated when you have done with this command. After doing with this, so if you still have any other dependence for your project, that should be done. So how you'd be doing is, pip space install space, what are the module name which is required for your project, that you need to write it here. Right, that module name you need to write. Right, so if you are writing this module name, it would be installed. But how could you know, like how come people know like how many modules are there, what are the modules which you require? So then in this case, write this command. So you need to write this command. That command is python space manage dot py space run server. So by doing this, what would be happened is, you would be able to run your project. So if you are running your project, what would be happen? If you have any other dependencies to be installed, it will show. Like in order to run with this project, I require so and so dependencies. So module not found error. Module not found error you'd be getting. So then in this case, what you do is press control C and then install pip space. What is the error you got? If you got numpy, so pip space install space numpy. So numpy module would be installed. So after installing numpy, now what again you need to do is for checking your project whether it is having any other dependencies or not. So then in this case, you again need to run this command python space manage.py space run server. So if you're doing it, if all the dependencies are clear, it will work fine. So if you have any other dependencies to be installed, it will show you an error. So let us consider this particular command here right now. I'll write that command. So in order to execute your project, python space manage.py space run server. If you do this, your project would be executed. Right? So your project has been executed successfully. So if your project has been executed successfully, you would be able to get this particular IP. So copy this IP or directly go to this particular browser and type the IP address. So when you type the IP address, your project would be displayed here. So this is for your project. So this is for your project. So this is how you execute your project. This is how you execute your project. How you import your project, how you import your database, how you import, how you install your dependencies. So this is what the particular process for that. Right. So now let us go with another process. So now here I have done with this particular process, first process I have done. So again you may get doubt here, so what if I want to do after like getting into this? So whether you need to do the registration, whether you need to do the login, you don't know. So for more detail about each and every individual project, in your project structure you would be having a video file. So this video file will be helpful for you to go with the additional process of your project. So right now I'm executing this particular video. So when you go with this video, they will show you the flow, whether to first login or whether first to register, they will show you. Right, so right now what I'm doing here is, I've executed my project. After executing my project here, now I go with this thing. So they're showing what are the URLs are available, how do you go with the URLs. So you need to do the registration, what kind of data to be placed, right? So what you need to do after registering, what is the login process. So those details are clearly mentioned here. So go into the project in depth about it, and you'll be having an enough idea about the project. Right? So this is how you people execute the project. Right? That's fine. So this is a method one. So that is using your PyCharm. That is using the PyCharm. So now here, coming to the method two, I'll show you the method two. So for the method two, let me consider another project. I'll show that project for you. Right. So here I have another project in the desktop. So I have extracted it here. So it is cloud-based multimedia protection. So here I'm showing you the method two. So method two for executing your project. Here what we do is, we don't use a PyCharm. Without using a PyCharm also, we can execute our project. So how that is done is, go to your project folder. Go to your project folder. So after going into project folder, you can find manage.py file. You can find manage.py file. So in this manage.py file is your directory. It is your working directory of your particular project. So let me show you that. So meanwhile, you need to even on your VAMP server. You don't require PyCharm, but you require the VAMP server. So click on VAMP server. When you double click on it, in the left side, right side below icon, you can find this VAMP server. So click on phpMyAdmin. This dashboard would be displayed for you. So now go back to your database. When you go to the phpMyAdmin, you can see something called as databases. So click on the database. Click on the databases. Right now, let me go with the database option here. So I got my databases. So click on it. You need to give the name. So what is the name you need to consider? I will show you. So let us go to that particular folder which I have created it. So right. So I'm going to the folder. In this folder, it is a long length name. I want to put it in the shortcut. So in this I have coding folder. So in this I have security M. So this is what my location of my project. So this is what my location of my project. Here is my database. So I'll go to my code folder. In this I can find manage.py file. So this is what my directory. So now what you people need to do is go to this file. Go to your project folder name. Cyber security is your project folder name. So I'm again on it. In this I can find settings.py file. Go to settings.py file. So in this, scroll a little bit down where you can find the databases. So here I can find the database name. So database name is multimedia protection. So I copy this. After copying this, now I come back to here, I paste my database name and I create my database. So after creating the database, you can see in the left side, now I need to import it. So import my database, click on import, go to the project directory where your database is there. So here on the desktop, this is what my project. So here I could find my database file here. Select this database file and click on go. So now what would be happen, your database would be imported successfully. It shows the number of lines of queries which has been executed. Number of lines of queries which have been executed, that would be displayed here. Right, so this, it will take a little bit of time. So after this, if you can find a folder or file called as, let's come back to the normal directory again. So if you can find a requirements.txt or help.txt, in this it will show you to which kind of modules you need to install. So if you're not having these modules, then it's not a problem. So then in this case, what you people need to do is, you people need to go with your command prompt. So what to exit, I'll show you. So here from the manage.py file you can find it, right? So that's fine. So the database also has been imported. So now here, what you people are doing is, in this address bar, completely arise, type cmd, here, pip space install space Django. So you need to install specific version. So which version you need to install, that we need to go to the folder in settings file. In settings file, you can find the version. So in the settings.py file, you can find the version. It is 1.11.6. So this version of Django should be installed. So pip space install space Django equal to 1.11.6. So by doing this, your Django would be installed. So after installing the Django, now what we need to consider is, we need to install MySQL client. So let us wait until this is done. So after doing with this, next command, as already discussed, pip space install space MySQLi client. So if you're doing with this, MySQL client would be installed in your system. It would be installed in your system. So pip space install space MySQL client equal to 1.3.12. for this you require the internet. If you are having a proper internet and proper connection, so if your network is being terminated or if you have some network droppage, it will not be installed properly. So check there is a good internet connection for this. So once it is done, so we need to type with our other command. So that command is pip space install space mysqli client. So here I wrote my command already. So this specific version we need to install it. So I'll be installing it here. So mysql client will be installed. So right now it's already installed in my system, so you got nothing to be installed again, so that's fine. So after installing mysqli client, now you need to go with a command called as pip space install space, sorry, the other versions which you need to install I'll show you here. Successfully install Django of the specific version. Right.
After installing Django,
right, now what we need to consider is python space manage.py. So if you write this command, it will show you whether other dependencies are there or not. So when I'm trying to execute this command, so observe here. So what it says, if there are no other dependencies, your project will run successfully. So now it says completely, like after getting this particular error, it says module not found, no module called as pyencrypt. So now what I need to do, I need to install this particular module. So how will I install this? For this what I need to do is pip space install space pyencrypt, like whatever the thing is that I need to write it. So by doing this, so observe here, I pasted my command here, clear my screen. So paste that particular command, copy it and paste it here. So that would be installed. So that particular thing, whatever the thing is there, that would be installed based upon your internet speed. So after installing it, now again I run my previous command, python space manage.py run server. So when I do with this, my project starts executing. So if you have still any other dependencies, that shows like this particular module has been not installed. So now I need to go with this module again, right? So here I have done with this, so it has been not affected properly. So that is why it says like this module has been not installed. So I need to install it again. So due to some technical issue in my this thing, it is being not installed. So now I need to install these other things also. Like it is saying like setup tools trust missing. So this module also should be installed. So now for this, first of all, I need to go with setup tools rust. So pip space install space setup tools underscore rust. So by doing this, that particular module would be installed. After installing that module, I need to install with this pyencrypt module. So in this way, what are the dependencies are there? So all those dependencies should be installed in my project. So then only it will work fine. If not, it will not work fine. So it has been installed. So now I install this pyencrypt module. So when I've installed it, it is working fine now, right now. Right, so it has some other issues with my settings. It's okay. Now I run my command and I check. So when I run my command, what would be happened is my server would be installed. My server would be installed. So now what I do is I'll install my server and show you.
in this way, what the other dependencies are there, we need to install. So like Python space, sorry, pip space install space, so into module, you would be installing it. So after that, you need to run this command. So when you run this command, what would be happen is your project would be opened. So how do you open it is Python space manage.py space run server. If you do this, your you'd be getting an IP address. Copy this IP address, go back to your browser and type 127.0.1. So by doing this, your project would be opened. So in this way, we'd be going with your execution of your project. So first one is from the PyCharm and second from is from your this thing. Second is from your command prompt. So from here, after this getting this thing, now go back to your project folder where your project folder is there. So in that, you would be finding a video, execute that particular video and check for the rest other process. By doing with this, you would be able to get your in-depth about your project. Yeah, thank you everyone. So if you people still have any other doubts regarding this project, you can mail us to tech@brainovision.in. So whatever the error you are having, please drop a mail, take a screenshot of that particular issue and what the process which you have done step by step. So please write that and drop a screenshot like what error you are getting to tech@brainovision.in or else hr@brainovision.in. So by doing with this, what are the issues are there, that issues will be resolved for you, right? So thank you everyone. So this is what your process of your executing of your project. So hope it's clear for everyone. Yeah, thank you for